maybe I was a freshman in college, and I had this magazine, and the magazine told me how to take a normal Radioshack wire, you know, with one and two ends, and how to rewire that to where you plug it into, at that time, a cassette player, for me anyway, and when you ran it into a mixer, you could change the phase on the mixer and bring everything together. Anyway, what it would do is it would end up eliminating the center image, and so on a recording, so much of the sound lives in this center, and then what happens to make it sound like it's spread out? There's reverbs and, you know, delays and that kind of move it out into the stereo field. And so when you remove the center image, you end up with basically what you're listening to is a bunch of reverb trails, and you're hearing all of these things that are completely buried in the mix when you have that center image, the center phantom image. So all that to say, what I did was, when I heard it, I was just completely taken by this. And so I started making mixtape after mixtape after mixtape of just these reverbs and all these, you know, everything the center removed. And to me, then this just became part of my musical language to have what I love this idea of taking something that's supposed to enhance an instrument and then bringing it into a song as an instrument itself. That's just something I love to do, and that's just kind of explaining what I'm about to do, and I'll be very quick about it. Why did I come to this guy's rehearsal?
Come on.
I don't need complete silence, but I feel like I need complete silence. Another one of my musical philosophies is honor thy mistakes. So I will not pitch you, if I do something screwy up here, I'm probably going to keep it in because I don't want to make you guys endure me getting everything perfectly right. It comes out a little different each time. Even though this song has no words, I like to think of it as a hymn.